Hello and welcome back to Microbial Concepts. Today we are going to talk about aflatoxin. Okay, so this is the small topic which is included in practicals for the masters. Okay, so I don't remember MSc part 1 or 2, but you have this and you have to study this because it is very important, as this is the toxin which is produced by fungi and it has carcinogenic properties and it causes serious poisoning illness, okay, or poisoning conditions. So we are going to talk about aflatoxin. So it is a naturally occurring mycotoxin, myco referring to the fungi, and it's produced by two types of molds, Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus parasiticus. Okay, it is also known to be a carcinogen. Okay, these molds, they occur in soil, decaying vegetables, hay and grains. Okay, it grows in favorable conditions like high moisture and high temperature. If we study worldwide, then the frequency of getting aflatoxin poisoning is more in South Africa. Okay, so there are around 13 types of aflatoxins produced in nature. Okay, so aflatoxins of concern are designated as B1, B2 and G1, G2. Okay, why B1, B2 and G1, G2? Because of the fluorescence that they show under UV torch. Okay, B as it shows blue fluorescence and green, G for green fluorescence. So these toxins are found together in various foods and feeds in various proportions, of which B1 is predominant and most toxic. Okay, so when a sample is analyzed by thin layer chromatography, the respective aflatoxin separates into individual components in blue fluorescence and green fluorescence. So we designate it as B1, B2, G1, G2, and when it is viewed under ultraviolet light, that is around 365 nanometer range, you will find out these spots which get separated. Okay, we commonly say it as a aflatoxin, but it has these parts, or we can say types, that it is a B1 and B2, so they can be mixed. They can be present in any proportion, but on analysis you will find out that one is there, or two aflatoxins are there, or three aflatoxins are there. Okay, so depending on their RF values, depending on their fluorescence, you can determine the presence. In animals, aflatoxin N is secreted in the milk and urine, which is a major metabolic product of aflatoxin B1. Okay, so in animals, if you need to find out the contamination is there or not, the aflatoxin M is tested or it is analyzed if it is present in milk or urine. Okay, then aflatoxicosis. Okay, so this is the condition of poisoning which is caused due to the aflatoxin. It is called as aflatoxicosis. So poisoning caused by the consumption of food contaminated with aflatoxin. So there are two forms. One is acute and second is the chronic. Okay, so acute severe intoxication, which results in direct liver damage and subsequent illness or death, whereas chronic is for the long time consumption on low dosages happening, so it can show some sublethal dose which have nutritional and immunological consequences. Immunological consequences as in immunosuppression. Okay, so these are the two forms, we can say, which are seen in aflatoxicosis, right? So this was about aflatoxin. This was the very basic video. Okay, remember, if you have this topic in details, you need to study more. This is regarding the practical exams. By that point of view, I had made this video, so this is the basic video. Okay, so I hope I had mentioned all the points, I had covered all the points, and this video is useful to you all. Okay, do subscribe to my channel and like my videos. Thank you.